Good morning. Today is day zero of Gen Con. I am staying with Jordan and Mandy, the designers of Lotus, which is totally awesome and you should check it out. So that's why it doesn't look like a hotel, or maybe it does. I don't know. They have a very adorable sign up. They have a few people staying here. So yeah, it is, according to my laptop, 6:15. So it's 9:15. And yeah, I asked Twitter if I should record a day zero vlog and you guys said yes, so here we go. First off and foremost, I have no Steve with me this year, which is very sad, but there's no buts, it's sad. Also, my computer, I use Final Cut Pro to edit videos, but my Final Cut Pro has been crashing a lot lately, so I am using Adobe Premiere now, and I don't have a lot of experience with Adobe Premiere, and so the edits on these videos probably aren't going to be up to my what I would prefer them to be, because I'm learning new software, but there we go, I'm going to use these vlogs to help me learn Adobe Premiere, so there we go. I like that. Welcome to the Gen Con Convention Center! Isn't it great? No, it's Target, I'm kidding.
I love Target.
Oh man, I was here last night. Oh, you know what I should do? I should show you guys the game section. That's what I should do, because Target, if you didn't know, is doing like exclusive releases of board games this fall. They're having 50 titles in Q4, I believe. Just exclusive to Target, and there's some pretty good ones in there, so I think we should go look at it. Oh, hey, there's Pokemon too. Oh. Well, they're like unboxing stuff, so that's promising. So here's card games.
So this Target said that they were doing a refresh.
Like right this second?
I don't know when. Yeah, it looks like it.
Oh, right here. It's Oregon Trail card game. Yeah.
Did it sell out?
And then this is the... So they have Codenames Deep Undercover, which is adults only. Yeah, and then they have the Bright Lights Big City Machikoro, they have Evolution in the beginning, they have Ticket to Ride First Journey, which I got and we played last night. It was fun, it was very enjoyable. It's what I wanted from a kid's ticket to ride, honestly. It was good. Yeah, I think that's it for the exclusives here. There's so many Pokestops right here by the Steak and Shake. There's a drowsy that popped up. Oh, you guys see, I'm just letting you guys take a break while I play.
Well, let him take a break too, he's carrying something.
Yes! All right, cool, I got the drowsy, we can go. Oh. All right, I'm waiting for my badge to get in the hall, but I got a program, and I want to show you guys just how many pages in the program all the stuff is, because they've expanded again. So not all of that is exhibitor, but a lot of it is. And then there's more event spaces, and they moved into the stadium even. So
Yeah, I don't think I will be able to show you all of Gen Con. There's a lot. All right, cool. So I am in Gen Con. It's obviously day zero. Everybody is still very much setting up. Lots of setup. I just love this part. Like, I feel like it's like a carnival family, and I'm part of the carnival family now. So yeah, it's just awesome. Also, there's the broken token booth. Oh my God, it looks amazing now. That's so crazy. Oh, I'm just going right for it, right for it. Look at this awesome new booth. All right.
You're like showing up everywhere.
So this is the booth that I'll be working at. You can see there's a lot of great, it's a work in progress. All right, just hang on, one sec, we'll fix it, wait. And there we go, now it's all set up. Ta-da-da! So if it wasn't obvious, I'm helping at the Gameland Games booth this Gen Con. We have it all set up. We're gonna have Epic Galaxies showing, Epic Tiny Kingdoms, and then Epic Defenders. And we're gonna have Epic Western out and available to see, though we don't have Epic Western for sale. Sorry. So yeah, if you want, come see me at booth 30. Oh God, just say it.
3043.
We're like, this is the back wall of the exhibit. You can see up there, there's the broken token sign. So yeah, just, there you go. So come see me here, 12 to 4 every day at Gen Con. So booth is set up. I have no idea what time it is. Oh, the broken token booth has lights. I'm sorry, I'm such a nerd for their products. So yeah, now I'm just wandering around, seeing what there is. I'm gonna go say hi to people, maybe help more people set up Star Realms booth. I'm looking for Portal games right now, because I'm also helping Portal. Let's see.
They all got happy.
Oh, super fight. There's Portal, and I'm stepping on bubble wrap. Portal! That's the one you all want, right? That one, right there, Cry Havoc. Check it out. Oh, these are damaged. So sad. Oh no. So sad. But that's okay, they got a lot. Oh, there's what I want, Tides of Madness. Oh. They also have board games that tell stories. I'm actually gonna, I don't know if Steve's watching these, but Steve, if you're watching this, just stop for a minute. Don't turn off the mute it, whatever, you know? I'm gonna get one of these for Steve, because I think he would really dig that. So yeah, there you go, that's Portal booth. I was hoping Chevy would be here. That's just a giant Mario cube thing. Oh my God, oh my God. Check it out. It's just a bunch of like awesome boxes. There's TARDISes and Mario cubes and Portal cubes. What? I'm gonna have to swing by later and see what that's about. But I'm going to go to the BGG booth. What up? There's a whole bunch of people loitering at the BGG booth. The Asmodee giantness. I don't know. They have like 4 or 5 booths. I see rails and sails. Right there. Oh, and they do have first journeys. Oh. And Seven Wonders Pantheon 2-player. I wonder if that's an expansion or standalone. Oh, dual. Duh. Expansion. Deuce Egypt. Nice. And they reboxed Citadels. Check it out. That's gorgeous. Oh, Steve's messaging me because puppies. Ooh, Plot Hat. Well, I was gonna go this way, but yeah. Junk art. They got the big wooden ones and the not big wooden ones. So there you go. I always like their tablecloths. I said Portal. Did I record Portal? I can't remember. But you did hear me talking about, ooh, Marco Polo.
Really? Yeah, I
have
no idea.
What's this? Oh, it's the Z-Man booth.
So you saw me talking about Seafall. So the deal with Seafall is Steve and I haven't been able to finish our Pandemic Legacy because it's just the two of us for the most part. So it doesn't make sense for us to get a Legacy style game when we can only play it 2-player for the most part, and we don't have enough consistent time and schedule to play it, and we have friends that will play it, so we're just gonna wait and see which of our friends get it to do that. That's that idea on Seafall. They're driving the carpet around. I was looking for the TMG booth to say hello.
trying to think what else you guys would want to see. Like, stacks of. The Fantasy Flight is that way. Ooh, Oceanos! That's the one I want. Check it out. Not even set up yet. Sorry, I'll be back tomorrow. Let's see. There's TMG. But nobody's here. They're already set up and done. So, yeah. There you go. All right. But there is Guildhall. Guildhall is the wrong game. There's Guilds of London under there. Spoilers. The Green Couch Games booth. Looking this way looks a lot cooler. Well, there's somebody.
Hey.
Just hide in that.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was trying to show them how many Guilds of London. Yeah, I'm GoProing.
You're GoProing, so this isn't like periscoping?
No, it's not live, it's edited. What?
Nothing. Hi, interwebs.
Do you know which stack is Guilds of London?
Yes.
Can I show them a sneak peek of how many there are?
There's 198 copies.
198 Guilds of London. Is it this one? So let's look. Oh, can you see?
No, totally. That's Orleans
Deluxe. There's Orleans Deluxe.
So some of the last ever copies in the world.
Yeah. Where's this one? There we go. Boom. So that's the table you want at the TMG booth. There you go. Awesome. Here's the Mayfair booth. They've got a nice extension. Very awesome. They have really good play space. Really good. And their carpet's always so comfortable because they put mats under the carpet. It's so nice. I just want to walk on it for my feet. Poaching explosion. That'll be a fun one. Alright, I was going to get a shot of how many they had of stuff, but it's just so busy in there. They're doing a lot. They're doing the flooring, which is like the worst time for anybody to come by with a camera. That's fine. There you go. You're in the vlog, yeah! AG booth. Check it out, they're setting up for their demos and everything. Super solid. Here's Fantasy Flight. Can see what they have. Or not. Yeah, yeah. They have so much. Let's see, what's that? Madness and Mansions, Armada. Check it out, guys. This is the Harry Potter Hogwarts battle demo area. Just looks amazing. So awesome. I'm excited to try this one. I'll definitely be demoing it and recording it and putting it in the vlog because I know a lot of you want to know about it. So there you go. Wandering around this point is definitely doing a maze. Like, aisles are blocked. There's trash everywhere. It's just kind of... I am happy that I don't have my Fitbit, but I'm also sad because it would be really interesting to see how much I was walking. This would be a lot. Ridiculous. So this is the Stronghold booth. So we got Dragon and Flagon, Terraforming Mars, Pursuit of Happiness, Cities of Spies. It's on a lot of people's lists. A lot of people's lists. I can talk. Oh my God, Stacey! Okay, I just saw someone. I'm super excited and I'm gonna go. I'm so excited they're here. I'm so excited. Guys, it's Pikachu! Pikachu's here, which means... it's Pikachu's butt!
Can't make that
up. And my boot's behind Pikachu's butt! I'm so happy. I'm so happy right now. Vast. That is a vast... well, it's not a vast pile of vast. The joke's lost, but look, it's vast, okay? But I saw somebody tweeted a picture and now I'm trying to find them based off of where they tweeted. Not sure it's gonna work. Covert Lotus! There's so much great stuff coming from Renegade. They also have Clank and World's Fair and Lanterns. Dark Sight! Such greatness. Kodama. There's so many good games. So tough to pick. Also, I'm just so happy Pikachu is here. So happy. It's a giant Vikings on board. That is pretty sweet. Pretty cool. I liked it. I played it. I didn't like love it, but I liked it. I also really love Dr. Eureka. Also, they made a giant one. I want this. I want this in my life. I wonder if they will sell me this set. For serious. Calliope Games booth. Awesome. Oh, North Star Games. Holy smoke. Upper Deck brought in a semi. Their booth is sick though, check that out. Yeah, so these are the games that were not pre-ordered, Cry Havoc. So these are just forever, first come, first serve. Those are all pre-orders in the back. So just so you know, this is what people are gonna be running for on Thursday.
Okay.
So Ignacy just pointed out something really cool. On the back of all their games, they have on here what the size of the cards are if you want to sleeve them before you open it. So right here, 44 by 68 millimeter for Cry Havoc. Everything's coming more together, and I think they actually turned on the AC finally. Thank God. Also, it just feels really much, it feels like I'm at home walking around with a camera pointing at my face in these halls. Really weird. Captain Sonar. Pretty cool. Also, Hit Zeroed, Looney Quest. They've got a lot. Well, they own a lot, so there's that. Let's see. There we go. That's gonna be packed tomorrow. Just crazy, crazy packed. And I'll be here. It's the gaming hall. This is probably where I'll spend a lot of my, maybe not, I don't know. I'm staying off site, so like I don't need to come here to do things late at night. But who knows? It's big. It's empty. It will be very full tomorrow. Very full. So when we got here at like 11:30, the will call line was already pretty long. So yeah, it's longer now. So we'll just so it's over there. You can't even see where it starts, and then it just. They have the Gen Con merch booth set up, but blind. They're closed. I'll go back tomorrow. Still a line. Still a line. Okay, the line totally goes outside. I'm not going outside. I'm going upstairs because I'm going to the JW to see JR. Honey. All right, you can see it. Line ends there. There you go. All right, so I've been up to things without you knowing, but right now we're at the JW Marriott Bar, and I found Maggie! And we are now going to the tapping, which is something I've never been to at Gen Con, so we shall see what this is about. Can we make it? There's so many Pokemon. There's like a gym right there that's constantly under battle. It is now. I have no idea.
We're going to the square, is what they called it.
I think it's just
where
generally
the trucks usually are.
That way.
Yeah, that.
We should walk through the AC convention hall though. The line is way huger. It's now, look, I don't know if you can see, it's now out the door and around the corner.
Is that just the, like,
that's the will call pickup.
Yeah, fuck that noise.
Yeah, no. All right, I snuck into the CGE room. It's not open yet, technically. They're here at training demo staff, and they're open, and I was like, I see something familiar. So I can't take this one because they're watching me, but check it out. It has inside of it both Codenames pictures and Codenames in the broken token insert. Look how gorgeous that is. Also, new art on the characters. Oh my god, it's a dog. I'm excited. That's pretty great. So yeah, tomorrow, 9 a.m. If you're watching this, it's probably already too late. But tomorrow, 9 a.m., this room will be open. You can come get them. If you haven't pre-ordered, be here at 9 a.m.
Yeah, exactly.
Also, so that art that I showed you, you get it. It's like a special pack. If you pre-ordered or you buy here, yeah, you'll get these, and it will make it so you can play with a 5x5 grid. Also, Broken Token has special cards, which are for if you buy their insert, and they are the promo cards for the words. So there you go. If you want the whole deal, come here, buy Codenames pictures, get the Codename picture promos, then go to Broken Token booth, get the Broken Token booth insert for it, and then you'll have everything that there is to have for Codenames. All right, let's go. Easy breezy beautiful. Do you think he uses CoverGirl? It's gotta be a little chilly down there. Also, totally, this is how I noticed him, cause of that ass. All right, now we're outside. This is like the food cart area. So there's food trucks. Sorry, Portland's making me say food carts. So food trucks, beer, stuff like that. It's pretty nice. Also, I've never been to the kegging, but here we are.
What are you doing? Are you just waiting for stuff?
Huh?
Are you waiting for stuff?
Was it really
a quarter or some sort?
I just remember last year was not great.
We got one of each. I like this one. Maggie likes that one. So it works out. Also, it's Chris.
And Hillary.
from Dog and Thimble Podcast. Also, I had to hide Terraforming Mars because it was getting way too much attention. Also, do I keep accidentally covering the mic? I'm sorry. There's been an entire adventure with the camera off. You don't even know. So many miles walked, so much bloodshed, tears, heartache. Also, we could eat our food from the food trucks at a closed Starbucks in the lobby of a hotel.
With air conditioning.
So much air conditioning. It's amazing. People have been calling, worried about our safety. Like, it's just...
No TV.
Maggie is helping me unbox Terraforming Mars. Here we go.
That's the first comment.
I'm going with the Little Mermaid. Yeah.
Like an evil queen is.
That's like a nice insert.
Oh my god.
Shiny. Oh my goodness. That's a good hat. Feel that.
Oh, nice.
That's nice.
Yeah, shiny.
That's nice.
Mine?
That's like plastic.
And more bags. And we got the plate. Oh, these aren't cardboard. I was thinking these cards. They're just mats.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah. And then a bunch of cards. Very nice. 1 to 5 players. Do you guys want to play? Alright, we are now going to Hot Games, I think, to punch Hot Games with Jordan and Mandy, who have joined us. And I'm still reading rules as we walk. All right, we are at the BGG Hot Games room, which doesn't have any hot games yet because we're all punching them. We're punching them. So this is a punching party. Punch, punch. There you go.
Punch with the camera, that's good.
Yeah. Eric was punching back there. So now we're just punching games.
We went to Chicago to stay with friends, but...
Yeah. So we're punching a bunch of Renegade games, and we've noticed they really like these black bags. Like, all the games have
the bags in them.
Escalators, escalators, riding along on the escalator.
I'm so glad this song is coming.
We are leaving the punching party and we are going to find more people. I wasn't recording any of that. Okay, the line is still going. I ran into Tony. The line is still going. It is also 10:34. The update on my life. Okay, we're at the JW Marriott again, and we found people playing games. So we're doing that now.
Had a few beers. It's not gonna happen.
We're doing Go Cuckoo now.
All right. I don't know. Double yellow.
I wish I had had enough battery to time lapse this.
The second level.
They're really enjoying it. They were all like, and now they're like, where can we get this?
Yeah, like total game face.
You're like rotating the nest.
Like, oh, we're gonna play this new dexterity game, and now it's like game face.
Yeah. There you go. Oh, she got on that third.
Alright, we've wrapped it up. I'm trying to get people out. We got the check. We're gonna go, maybe soon. I gotta edit a video. It's a thing. Okay, so we figured it out. I may or may not be getting up really early to go to the press line, so we gotta cut it short, you know, like at 11:40 at night. So, some folks wanted to say something to ya. Good night.